The next in line is Dr. JayaKrishna, RUHS. Yes.
Thank you very much. Now, sir, last time avakasha siktu nanage. Good afternoon, orgo bandide. ಇಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಿಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಹುಡುಗರೆಲ್ಲ ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ಕು ವಾಟ್ಸಪ್ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮುಗಿಸಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅಂತ ಭಾವಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಈಗ ನಾನು ಹೇಳೋದನ್ನು ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊತೀರಾ ಅಂತ ಭಾಳ ಆಶೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಈಗ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಾನು ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡೆಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ಯಾನಲ್. ಮದನ್ ಸರ್ ನೋಸ್ ಮೀ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಡೆಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ವೆರಿ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟೈಮ್. ನನಗೆ ಈ ಇವಾಗ ಐ ಗಿವ್ ಎ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಯುಷ್. ಐಲ್ ಬಿ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಯುಷ್ with oral health care. It is my firstly it's my honor and privilege to be sharing with sharing this dais with eminent panelists and shrestas in this respective field. Sir, it reminds me of a verse from Gita, chapter 3, verse 27. Yad yad acharati shrestah tat tad evo itara janah sayat pramanam krute lokas tad anuvartante, which means whatever action is performed by great men and women, the common people follow in their footsteps, and whatever standards are set by this by their exemplary acts, the world pursues. As we all know, I'll be talking about briefly about integration of Ayush into oral healthcare system, and I'll be talking about brief dental illnesses and the common factor approach and certain diseases which can be cured through Ayush and its methodology, and about the strategies how we can integrate Ayush with the mainstream oral health services. Firstly, I would like to quote, the healthy mouth mirrors a healthy body, and good oral care is important to maintain a good oral health. Oral diseases are universal and widely prevalent. There are many forms of diseases such as dental caries, periodontitis, malocclusion, developmental anomalies, and oral cancer. As the main aim of Ayush is prevention of oral disease without altering the oral microbial flora, and unlike in Western medicine, without any side effects and use of any synthetic materials. Advantages of incorporating Ayush in oral healthcare are reaching the unreached, holistic approach, easy affordability, and common risk factor approach. There are certain etiological factors such as high diet, obesity, stress, poor oral hygiene, which all lead to smoking and alcohol, and these are interlinked again with cardiovascular diseases, diabetes, and in turn these lead to dental caries, periodontal disease, and traumatic health injuries. There are certain papers published on the use of traditional natural ingredients and herbs available in nature and their efficacy in the treatment of periodontal diseases, candida associated denture stomatitis, treatment of pyorrhea, dentin formation, treatment of odontalgia, and ulcerative stomatitis. Yoga and breathing exercises like pranayama are found to have an effect on physiological activities in our body, and in turn have positive effect on the oral health. It is found to be effective in the treatment of lichen planus, bruxism, burning mouth syndrome, myofascial pain dysfunction syndrome, dry mouth, and which are all believed to be ailments caused by stress, anxiety, and depression. Use of natural phytochemicals are found to be effective alternate to antibiotics and present a promising approach in prevention of treatment of dental infections. Thus, use of certain herbs in mouthwashes, toothpaste, and gum paints are found to be effective in prevention of dental caries. Development of plaque and calculus in turn prevent gum infection and bad breath. Oil pulling is one of the old and tested procedure which involves swishing of the oil in the mouth, which prevents decay, bad breath, bleeding gums, and strengthens the teeth and the gums. Lastly, I'll be talking about the strategies of integration of Ayush into oral healthcare system. In collaboration with the Dental Council of India, my friend is there here, Dr. Jaikar Shetty, who is a Vice President of Dental Council of India. I would like to tell him, Ayush should be incorporated into the existing dental curriculum and should be reinforced in universities and institutions. Every BDS graduate should have a knowledge of Ayush materials and treatment methodology, which also includes pranayama and other breathing exercises. Certain yoga postures are very effective in controlling the anxiety of the dental patients. Main problem of dentistry is treating the anxiety of dental patients. Probably we can incorporate these breathing exercises and yoga postures, or they should be taught to our dental students, BDS and MDS graduates for effective anxiety management. There should be an increase in grants to research and development of natural and oral hygiene products. A certified courses and interdisciplinary PhDs should be developed for BDS and MDS graduates on integration of Ayush with oral care. Once all this is achieved, Ayush is sure to flourish in every corner of this country, along with Western medicine, so to bring about the integrated approach in treating oral health concerns. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. I thank ABUP for giving me this opportunity to speak to you on this day. Thank you very much.